It's Ferdinand Tutorial. Let's talk about microbiology. Now, in our previous classes, we've been talking about courses under microbiology. But today, we want to talk about the course, the meaning of microbiology, the organism, the groups of organisms that are microorganisms. Are you getting it? Now, let's talk about microbiology. We said that microbiology is a study of microorganisms. Now, when we're talking about microorganisms, we mean organisms that are too small to be seen by the unaided eye. Now, such microorganisms include, we have bacteria, we have fungi, we have virus, we have protozoa, we have what? Algae. Now, microbiology doesn't only study this microbiology. It also studies their form, their structure, and their interaction with the biotic and abiotic components of the environment. Now, having known that, we said a microorganism ranges from a size of 1 millimeter in diameter and below. Are you getting it? Now, this microorganism can be classified as unicellular or multicellular. Now, unicellular, when we mean that they have one cell, and multicellular, they have more than one cells. Now, microorganisms also have the characteristics of other living organisms, where we have movements, reproduction, nutrition, irritability, excretion, reproduction, and what? Death. Are you getting it? Now, having seen this now, we say that broadly, we can classify microorganism broadly based on its cellular architecture. We can classify it as a prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Now, prokaryotic in the sense that it lacks nucleus and other cell membrane organelles. While eukaryotic in the sense that it has a complex cell arrangement which contains nucleus and other cell membranes. Now, with these two classifications of microorganism based on their cellular architecture, we can group microorganism into five kingdoms, where we have the kingdom Monera, the kingdom Protista, the kingdom Fungi, kingdom Animalia, and what? Kingdom Plantae. Now, coming to kingdom Monera, the microorganism present in kingdom Monera is what? Bacteria. Now, kingdom Protista, the organism present there is what? Protozoa and algae. Now, the third one there, the kingdom Fungi, it is only fungi that is present. And the fourth one, kingdom Animalia and kingdom Plantae, are macroorganism. The first three is microorganism. The last two is what? Macroorganism. Now, with this kingdom, we can group microorganisms into five. Remember that we said we have bacteria, we have protozoa, we have algae, we have fungi, and we have what? Viruses. Let's start with bacteria. Now, bacteria are unicellular organisms. Their size ranges from 1 to 5 millimeter diameter. Now, they are smaller in size, that is to say. Now, they are found in almost all the environment. That's bacteria. Are you getting it? Now, they have both harmful and what? Beneficial effect to other organisms. Now, the next one there, we have protozoa. Now, protozoa, we say that they are animal-like protists. Are you getting what I said? Now, they move from one place to another. That means they have locomotive organelle. They can be free-living or what? Parasitic. That is for protozoa. Now, the third one there is algae. Now, algae is, we can say that they are plant-like in nature. Are you getting it? They contain chlorophyll. That is to say they photosynthesize. Are you getting it? But we find them majorly in what? In aquatic environment. That is for algae. Now, the third one there is, we have virus. Now, when we are talking about virus, there are virus is an acellular infectious agent. Are you getting what I say? Now, they replicate inside the host of a living organism. Now, this virus contain protein and what? And nucleic acids. Are you getting it? Now, this virus cause diseases to both what? Plant and what? And animal. Now, let's talk about fungi, which is the last one. Now, we said that fungi are eukaryotes. Are you getting it? That means they can be unicellular or what? Multicellular. Multicellular, in the sense that they include moss and mushroom. I get unicellular in the sense that they contain what? Yeast. Now, this when fungi exist in multicellular, they contain filaments. They contain filaments. Are you getting what I say? And hyphae, which abbreviate together to form what? To form mycelium. Are you getting it? Now, that is it for what? For fungi. Now, they also have beneficial and what? And harmful effects. Now, we have some fields in microbiology. When we are talking about fields, we have some fields in microbiology. We have environmental microbiology. That's microbiology that is related to the environment. We have public health microbiology. We have medical or clinical microbiology. We also have food microbiology, where the interaction of microorganisms in our food. We also have industrial microbiology, how we isolate microbiology, use them in the industry, their uses. Are you getting it? And we also have research. Now, when we're talking about research, this involves scientists going through the wide to study microorganisms. Are you getting it? That's why we have bacteriologists, those who study bacteria. We have virologists, those who study viruses. We also have mycologists, those who study fungi. We also have protologists, those who study what? Protozoa. Parasitologists, those who study protozoa, Now, that is it. Now, that will be the end for this class, for this microbiology class. I'll be hoping to see you again next Tuesday in my next phase of class. Thank you. Please, I want to beg you one thing. Please subscribe to this channel. Like, share to your friends. Also, comment your question if you have any below. And also, share to your friends. We hope to be seeing you again next Tuesday. Do have a lovely day.